Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. My dear students, Assalamu alaikum. I am Dr. Hassan Jaleel Shah and I am Advisor Human Resource Development in HEC. Today I'm going to talk about a very exciting project that we have launched just yesterday. That is the US-Pakistan Knowledge Corridor. Now, what is the background of this US Knowledge Corridor is that there has been a group which we call as the Education, Science and Technology Working Group, that is between the US and Pakistan. Under this working group, we have established that over a period of time, we will be training more than 10,000 Pakistani students in leading US universities so as to bring back rich knowledge with them and contribute to the knowledge economy of Pakistan. In phase one of this project, we are going to send about 1,000 students for PhDs in the highest ranking US universities for the PhD. This will continue till 2024. This is a very exciting scholarship project because approximately we will be spending about more than $100,000, that is $100,000 to $120,000 on each student that we will be sending to the leading universities in UK, in USA, sorry. As I said, that the basic purpose is to contribute in the knowledge economy and to enrich our academia with the highest possible education that they can get. What we are going to pay, what does this scholarship covers? The scholarship covers, first of all, the monthly allowance, which will be quite decent, that you'll be able to live in that allowance. Then we will be also be getting you health insurance. We will also be giving you an initial settlement allowance. Once you reach over there for the initial settlement, we'll be giving you that. And we will also be giving you a return airfare. So that is about it. As far as the tuition is concerned, now there are three segments of the tuition. Those who are able to secure admission in the top 50 ranking QS, time higher ranking universities, we will be giving them full tuition, irrespective of the cost of this the tuition. So get ready for this one. We will be fully supporting you. The second category are those that are able to get admission in the 300 top ranking QS ranking universities. We will be bearing their tuition, provided it is within our the laid down limits. And beyond 300, we expect you that when you get admission, you secure the tuition waiver from that university, and remaining expenditures, we will be bearing the remaining expenditures. Now, what we have done is that we have undertaken a number of the document of understanding, our memorandum of understanding, with about 9 to 10 universities, based on which these universities are going to waive off the tuition requirements for them. And we are in the process of negotiation with another 10 to 15 universities to get the same waiver from them. Now, we expect that those universities which are not giving you a tuition waiver, we expect that we get you the status of RA, our research assistants, our teaching assistants, so that your tuition cost is covered in that in the amount that you get over there. The final date for closing of this is 10th of January, and the age, you know, is that for the common student it is 35 years of age, and for those who are already in the faculty, it is 40 of age on the date of closing of that, when the application is closed. Those who have 18 years of education, they are eligible to apply, and those who have 16 years of education, and if the universities are willing to accept them for the direct admission into PhD, they can also apply for this scholarship. We will definitely be asking you to sign a bond of post your qualification or award letter. We'll be asking you to sign a bond with us, that in which you give us a commitment that on your return, you will be serving the Pakistani institution, academic institution or research institution. And those brilliant students, we will certainly looking for the brilliant students, so we would not accept anyone having a third division in their profile. What you're going to do now is that get yourself registered for this scholarship, apply for this scholarship which we have announced yesterday. And the different documents that are asked, you please upload these documents. Now, you have also to surf the website of the leading US universities and find an department or university which is of your interest. Now interact with the faculty of those universities and get into negotiation to secure an admission in those universities. And when you have secured that admission, then come back to us. If it is, as I said in the beginning, if it is in the first 50, so we will be giving you a pat with all the perks and privileges. If it is in the 300, then again, we will be giving you certain waivers in that case. Those students who do not have admission, they apply for them. We will be administering a test over here, and then we will be determining their merit criteria over here. Certain universities, there are different requirements. Certain universities, rather most of the university will be asking you to forward a motivation letter as well as a research proposal. So you will very well understand that research proposal is the basic foundation on which you have to undertake your research pursuits. Now this research proposal has to be very robust, very strong and complete in all aspects. That is very important. The motivation letter, similarly, it should be academically written and you must seek guidance of your faculty in the university or you may attend certain workshops. As far as the GRE is concerned, we are going to help you even in the GRE. What we are going to do is that soon we will be putting an ad on our website in which we will be asking you to apply for the GRE. We will make you cohorts of 30 students, 30 to 35 students in each group, and we will hire, we will be getting resource persons to give you very good training on the GRE, as well as we will also be including the aspects of research proposal and as well as the motivation letter. So please do not miss that opportunity of getting into that GRE training sessions. Now this is not only limited to the applicant of the US Knowledge Corridor. Other students also who are willing to study and even in the undergrads and the postgrad, the various level of the USA, studies in USA, they must attend this GRE workshops. We will be asking you to contribute very little in that because it's a we have to pay to the resource persons, so bulk of the expenditure will be borne by us, and just to have that your interest remaining in that workshops, we will be asking you to contribute a little amount from your side so that your seriousness remains in that workshop, right? So this is about it. The common mistake is that do not bank only on the HEC. After you have applied, please get into contact with the various universities, but keep in mind that keep your aim high. That is, focus on the top-ranking universities. And the top-ranking universities will not accept you unless and until you have a very robust and very solid research proposal as well as the motivation letter. So that is a common mistake that the people then, when they have applied, they do not pursue their interest overseas. And also prepare for the HAT test. Those who do not have a GRE, valid GRE or valid admission, since they have to undertake the HAT test. So please get yourself very well prepared for the HAT test so that you score and you are able to be selected over there. The provisions I have already previously I have stated that it's well covered. You will be able to live in this stipend that we give, and hopefully you will be able to bring back a very good degree with you and enrich the knowledge economy of Pakistan, as well as contribute very valuable through your addition, knowledge addition in our faculty. I wish you the best of luck and encourage most of you to apply for this scholarship and seek admission in US universities. Thank you very much.